Hello, hello. It is Saturday, September 17th, 2022. For watching Quoth the Raven, Lewis Bright Raven. I'm your artist, Lewis Bright Raven, 30-year veteran. And it's been a hell of a long time since I've done a live draw. Apparently the last one I did was back in May, so we have lots of stuff to do. I'm going to start off with a character called the Nebulizer. This is from a crowdfunded book by Brian Rodman. This is the character. You see some more of the characters. He shoots mutated monsters out of germs. He's in a special suit because he is one of those people who was excessively allergic to things, and his suit has the chemicals in there to keep him protected from all the different germs. He's kind of like a bubble boy in an armor suit shooting these monsters. Again, that is Brian Rodman Presents the Nebulizer number one, and you can get that book at the BrianRodman.com website. Please check the description of this video below for the link. And that's what we'll start with first. I've already done a little bit of a blue line. I don't know if you guys can see it. It's fairly light, but it is there. I always tend to go with the start with the blue lines before a show, simply for speed purposes, expediency. But let's go ahead and get started. With the more finished piece here. Now, I'm not drawing exactly the same design as Brian. I'm doing a little bit of a change up here. Not because Brian's design is bad or anything. I just wanted to add a little of my own flair to it. He's got a little extra tunic over his suit. Kind of helps him keep clean, but instead of all those splattered germs all over his wetsuit, shall we say, adds extra layer of protection. Makes it a little more post-apocalyptic, because that's sort of what the story does. It takes place in this weird future where humanity has been kind of wiped out by these germ monsters. And he's the only one left, apparently, or at least so far. I also added a few items to his suit. He doesn't wear a belt in the thing, as you see, but I've added a belt in here because he has the small gun And I figured that you had to have a holster for the gun. Well, you gotta have a holster, you don't have a belt to put it on, so. Add a little pouch on the belt loop here. It's got some canister bombs here. Get my ruler, make sure those are straight. Now I am going to go ahead and go into a full color illustration on this. So the pencils are going to be a little rough. As we go. I don't know who else is going to be watching or not watching, of course. There was someone in the room. They didn't say hello. That's quite often typical. If you do happen to be in the room, feel free to say hello in the chat. Mark Andrew Smith. Hey, Mark. Good to see you. We're starting off with Brian's character, but we will get into drawing characters from Gladstone's Scofield Conquerors, hopefully, as well. That is the plan. Over the next 4 hours, then we'll be doing this live show. When we get to the Gladstones, we're going to talk about his Kickstarter campaign, Mark's current Kickstarter campaign for GLADSTONE'S REVENGE. And we're also going to have something kind of cool. There was an earlier project that Mark put out for Kickstarter, so that I have extra copies of. So we will hopefully discuss that as soon as we get this one. Girlfriend was monopolizing time. Yeah, that's cool. Almost bedtime in his part of the world. Really? Okay, I'm trying to think. What is it, 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock there in Riyadh? Or he's in Saudi Arabia, folks, teaching. English is a second language over there. Mm-hmm. 8 o'clock, okay. And he goes to bed early because Friday is the Sabbath over there, so they actually have classes in the morning on Sunday. Mm-hmm. And he swam a lot today, so apparently. So he's extra tired. I don't know what that show is, so. Is it a boring show? Or I know that that's kind of funny to say, because, I mean, heck, I fall asleep watching stuff I shouldn't fall asleep watching, but I do all the time, so. Case in point, I didn't watch wrestling last night because I slept through it. Then I knew it was probably going to happen because I was pretty wiped out yesterday, anyway, after the podcast. It's an amazing show. Okay. I'll have to take your word for it, I guess. I'm really not. WWE is coming out of Saudi Arabia, right, in November. Roman Reigns versus Logan Paul. That's cute. Well, it depends on how expensive it is. I mean, my goodness. Those guys. Charge obscene prices for things anymore. I just. I always get upset. Well, I don't get upset. I mean, whenever WWE or AEW come to Colombia, and I go check the ticket prices, and I just go, nope. It's not worth it. Partly because it's a different experience watching it in the stands, and a lot of times, you know, especially if you're not right up there, up close, you're watching it on the monitor above the ring anyway, so what's the point? If you're gonna watch it on the Tron above the actual live match, then there's not much point in going. Again, that's just my opinion, but let's see here. Got a lot of ear tubes and fluid tubes all over the place, trying to keep himself protected. At least you're keeping yourself in shape, Mark. Yeah, swimming helps a lot. That's better than I'm doing. I'm unfortunately. We're just well, I'm not yo-yoing, I'm just going up and up and up and up, unfortunately. Like I said, that's, you know, kind of my, that's my problem though. I mean, I don't know what's going on. I do and I don't. I've started cutting out some things, but who knows how long it'll take. And just because you've cut something out of your diet doesn't mean you're going to immediately start losing weight, of course. You're going to have to do other things as well. So I don't know. We'll see what happens. I want to get these kind of... gassy, smoky rings here. Put in there real quick. I wish I could do that. Disciplined diet. What's that? Of course, half my problem is my crazy sleep schedule. If you're up all night, like I usually am, you end up doing kind of foolish things sometimes, like eating in the middle of the night when you shouldn't be. Even though I'm not going to go to bed for hours, you know, it's not good. Definitely, if you can do it, all the power to you. Go for it. Get healthy. Stay healthy. But just because I know Mark said he's probably going to have to come back and watch, I'm going to show you. There's a quick, very brief thing of Martian Jones there. A little bit of Kid Nefarious and Libertina from the Kid Nefarious one shot. So that's what I'll be doing later on, hopefully, in this episode. That's the plan, anyway. I want to not rush this because I have to go ahead and go into colors and inks. This lovely using a little bit different pencil here. Hopefully, yeah, that worked much better. Okay. Still gotta find it. Okay, here we go.
Thank you.
Okay. That's cool. Thank you. Appreciate that, Marv. Didn't realize you were off. Yeah, I just got a message from you. That was from yesterday's show, so I didn't know. That's cool. But enjoy your time at the beach. Let's see here. I'm gonna put this side by side here. This is Brian's character, and this is my version of it. then to the first steam feeling with it. I'm trying to decide, because on the cover he's got a grayish, but in the inside it's more brown, different brown and gray. And the other ones, it's gray, and I'm just not really sure what the color scheme should be. I'm thinking it should be gray tones with the blue highlights, but yeah, you see what I mean? I mean, it's brown there basically because he's in a fiery blaze of stuff, but I'm thinking I'm going to go ahead and go with the darker gray type stuff. So before we get into that, let me find my brush pen. I thought it was right here. It isn't. That's not nice. Well, that's that kind of pen, which is fine. That's just not what I was looking for. That's a little bit thicker, I can live with that. I would like to know where my brush pen is. If I have to ink that, I'll be there all day. Let's see if any of these are solid. Nope, not that one. I thought I had a brush pen right by here. I'm a little bit annoyed right now. Yeah, that'll do. Maybe this pen won't do. Kind of getting a bleed effect. I don't know. me. I thought I had a question in there, dude. Okay. It's over there, of course. Be right back, folks. See? Backpack. Alrighty. Let's see what we can do with this. Flip it this way. I like that word. Thank you. I'm not getting the effect I want. That's annoying. I may have to go over here and use these pens, which is fine. Yeah, that's better. Yeah, that comes out really much cleaner. Much better. Okay. Mess with this here. Yeah, I added a shoulder pad to his armor. I don't know why, it just looked better to me in my mind's eye, I guess. Like I said, this isn't an exact duplicate of Brian's design. This is my interpretation. Sorry if I'm quiet while I draw. I don't always think about talking while drawing. That maybe that's part of the problem with the video when I did the live draw, because I don't get that many people watching live, and I think that's probably part of the reason why. My brain says, hey, wait a minute, you're on TV, talk, stupid. anyway, smile, you're on YouTube camera. Anyway. Yeah, I haven't really been doing a whole lot drawing-wise lately. And part of it was depression, and part of it was other things going on. Another person telling me they're watching something else or doing something else right now. That's fine. Of course, just because Peter Smith's having an art auction doesn't mean I'm not having an art auction at some point in this video. Or maybe not an auction, but a sale. You know, got plenty of time here. We've only been on an hour. Got 3-4 more hours to go, guys. So, you know, is it really bad timing? Are you just, you know, using it as an excuse? Anyway, as I was saying before I got that message, part of it's been depression, something I deal with not too often anymore. No reason to really talk about it here. I kind of wish that the art was more therapeutic. Be much more, hey, I could get out of my depression by drawing. But unfortunately, part of the reason I have the depression is the drawing. I know that sounds crazy, but you're not. Entirely happy with your work, or you're not getting the desired results, whether it's the actual physical work or appreciation for the work or whatever, it tends to make the process a lot more banal. Not as much fun anymore. And that depresses me. Now this is okay. You know, I'm doing it partly for fun, partly because Brian, the designer of this character, creator of this character, had mentioned he's kind of having some issues himself and having to put his comics on the back burner to do some other stuff. Still creative stuff, but you know, he's got some health issues, and drawing isn't working for him right now. So I thought maybe, you know, if I did something that might help inspire him a little bit, or maybe if I got into this, some of you folks could check out his page there. Again, the link is in the description below. Maybe that would help motivate him down the road to get back to the second issue of this series. But like I said, he's had some health issues lately. He's got chronic asthmatic and other issues, I believe. Okay. I'm going to be right back. Notice something on my hand that I don't want to get on the picture here. So just give me a moment here. I don't know if you heard the monster, but the fur monster is here. Let's go back to the drawing here. What are you doing? He wants attention. Of course. Hello, little one. Hello, little one. Go lay down. Okay. Yeah, that kind of annoyed me a little bit there with the bad timing because someone else is having an art auction. I mean, you know, if we play that game, then I'm also not even doing podcasting anymore because there's always somebody else podcasting opposite me that's more popular, more cool. So, I don't know. But it is what it is. I mean, you know, people have the right to choose what they want. They want to go watch someone else, let them watch someone else. All I can do is what I do. It's kind of like certain people as of late that I've tried to make some sort of reconciliation with about certain things because of things that were said by other people, and apparently they've got a mad on against me for it, and I'm like, what's the deal? And, you know, they're not talking to me, so I can only do, you know, what I can do. If you don't want to talk to me, clear the air or resolve your issue, then I guess that's that, you know, you move on. And yes, I will get to coloring this. I realize I've been working on it for a little bit over an hour here, maybe an hour and a half maybe by now. Sure, I'll get it done and get probably one of the gladstones done before the end of the show. As far as the drawing part of it, I may go a little bit longer, showing you some of the artwork here shortly, but because we don't want to get you guys who might be watching in. But to not see the other stuff, I promise, but we'll see. So go here. I'm trying to figure out what I want to do. Okay, that's what I'm going to do. All right. But oh, someone asks, when am I going to draw my own characters instead of someone else's? Depends on some stuff going on here this weekend. I don't know. We'll see. I might do some stuff with my characters here later today or tomorrow. I don't know. If not, then possibly next week. If people actually start watching the live draw, yeah, I don't know. I'm kind of thinking that way about it. Whoops, you're not seeing it because it's flat there. Okay, sorry. I was just trying to get a better angle for my hand. That's all right. Someone asked me, why don't I draw at my drawing table? Partly because the way my camera is, I can't get the angle right. What happens is it's coming over my right shoulder, so you're always seeing the hand over the drawing. You never get to see the drawing. So there's that problem. And also, it's just not a comfortable setup, unfortunately, right now. I'm wanting to get a different board to set this up on so I can draw. It's like a light board, a light table board. And unfortunately, I don't have the money for it right now. Mm-hmm. That's one of the good things about doing the live draws, though, is that maybe if you guys buy some of this cool stuff when I get it done, I can buy it, and then I can do live draw on a more regular, consistent basis. The other possibility is me getting a different camera set up, but the camera is even more expensive than the light tape or the light pad thing. So I'd rather just get the light pad for now. If I'm being honest, the light pad's only like, I don't know, maybe 80 to 120. But getting the cameras and then getting the computer set up so it'll run the camera and getting a cord that's long enough. We're talking like $200-$300 easy. So I don't know. Let's see. If only my tax guy ever pays for his artwork he owes me money for, I can go get that stuff. When is season 5 starting? As soon as I can get the opening sequence ready. I'm still working on that. That's all right. I can just do it that way. Yeah, that looks all right. I don't care for this ruler. Grab some of the ink and make it bleed. I don't like that. From the cork underneath it, you can kind of see some of the spottiness there. That's from older pieces, but I don't want to do it on this one. So I might go freehand for a lot of this for the rest of the way. Or maybe I'll just use Something else is a straight edge. Aha. Can always do that. Oh, okay. Someone just asked me why I wasn't at a local thing going on at my comic shop. And, basically because I wasn't asked to be there. yeah, I don't always do the events if they don't ask me. I got other things going on, you know, so.
Someone just asked me if I can get this done in under 2 hours. Probably not. You're asking me to finish the whole thing, inks and colors, in 15 minutes. What am I doing? Tie-dyeing it? Maybe people just don't have the patience. I mean, I know these take a while and stuff, but and I do wish I had the speed that I used to do stuff at, but I don't. Part of that is age, part of that is me not drawing as often as I used to. And if you don't draw as often, you work slower. So it's kind of like everything else. Practice, practice, practice. We're just saying you get good. You're good or you're fast or you're good and fast or whatever, but I don't know. But maybe when I get myself back in the regular schedule and doing these, I can do your stuff again. I don't know. Like I said, dealing with the depression, the drawing, it just makes it for me a lot more difficult. It's kind of wish that the some of my friends that I've helped promote who do drawing, live draws on their shows, they never invite me to draw. And maybe because they figure out I'm gonna be too anxiety or something, or maybe they think I'm gonna embarrass them or something because I'm not drawing as well as I should or something. I don't know, but the truth is, if you invited me to do something, it would probably, spark more, I don't know, not competitive nature, but at least, they want me to draw. Okay, I can draw if they want me to, type of thing, whereas I don't feel like I get that always. Most people are asking me more opinion than anything else, and I don't know. You know what they say about opinions anyway, so we're not going to get into that. One thing I do wish, I wish I found my other template for the circles as opposed to ovals, but sometimes the angles are wrong on these ovals, but just gotta do what you gotta do, I guess. Someone just asked me, can you see me draw comics pages as opposed to a sketch or whatever? We'll see. I'm trying to figure out things as far as what I want to draw and commit to anymore. I know that sounds kind of weird, but it's hard to explain. It goes back to just, that sense of why am I doing this again? Playing with the depression. Another thing I wish I could do is play music on the show, but because of the silly copyright stuff, I just get my videos turned off. We don't need that. So we're almost getting to the coloring point.
Okay. See if I can spell write some stuff here. Oh yeah, that's not a problem. It comes out, that's good. Give me a moment, folks. Eyes are starting to bother me. It's a good thing I had to color it with gray in that area. So I'm not too worried about it. I'm going to undo these so I can get a better angle on this. I'm probably going to have to. Oh, yeah, definitely going to have to. Okay, no problem. Actually, that's
Starting to have a not a vision thing, but a sleepiness type thing that I have sometimes, but I'm gonna try and work through it. Hopefully I won't start having other issues. Mm. Okay.
I'm starting to get a headache. Oh, that's not good.
I may have to take a break after I finish the logo here for a moment. And we'll talk a little bit, and I'll show some finished pieces that I have for sale. Let my eyes rest a few minutes. Because it's because I've been drawing with my glasses off, which I have to do sometimes, or it's because of other things. I don't know for sure what's going on, but my head's starting to get a really bad headache. I'm not right now, for sure. Okay.
I forget what's going on with my eyes.
I'm going to make this part one, and I'm going to come back a little later and do the colors on this and the Gladstone's stuff later tonight, because it's just one of the best cool things to put. Headache I can't deal with. But we will finish the inks on this. And that will remain this one. Part one, and then come back to part two. Later seating. Probably around 8. What time is it now? 4? Oh, I said I'd go to 5. Maybe I can do it. I don't know. Let's see here. I don't want to wreck this after putting the time in. That's what I'm worried about with my eyes. Doing what they're doing. I suppose it was drawn till I fall asleep or something. I'm gonna do a deal. But I don't think that would be very good.
Let's see here. We got one more thing to do with that. So, okay. There's the line art for the character. I do need to fill in the glove on the black there. I almost forgot. It's a good thing I picked that up. So that wasn't right. We're going to go with the grays, and there will be some colorings, of course. I'm not sure if we're going to go with a reddish brown for the over smock tunic or not. Wondering why I stopped the way I did, because my eyes won't worry.
Probably, I don't know. Whoa. Sorry, so my eyes and my hair. Really starting to bother me. I don't know what I'm gonna do here. I know I gotta get this covered somewhat, so let's go and just keep trying. Hopefully I won't pass out of sleep here from the headache. But it is getting there for my vision does not look to do what it needs to do. But we will endure. Yeah, I'm gonna have to take a break after I get the pants done. I can't go anymore without screwing it up. And we don't want that, so. It's just that I need some, my eyes need some rest or anything else. And once my eyes stop hurting, the headache will go away. I will try to be back in a little while. So we can get those Gladstone pieces. But if I don't, for some reason, I will come back and do those on Sunday. And this is not the final color either. There's a lot of coloring here. It's not fluid. This is just a undercolor, I guess you could say, for the gray. But we'll keep with it. Sorry, folks. Okay. Well, that's all I'm going to do for now, I think. We'll come back later tonight after I've had Chip's eyes rest. That's what I get from not having drawn for so long, I think. This is where we got so far. Let me go ahead and put that out there. And again, character. So you see, I gotta go a little bit more of a bluish gray on this, and I'm gonna go back into it and do it, but not right at this moment. We'll go ahead and set this aside. Just resetting the camera to its normal position when I do these shows. Just give me a moment and I'll be on the screen again. Hello, hello. I think you can tell just by looking at my face that my eyes are a little swollen. I need to take a break, but I didn't know that was going to happen, unfortunately. But I probably should have, because it's been so long since I've actually sat down and drawn it for an extended period. Again, I will be back later this evening, probably, I want to say 8 or 9 o'clock. I don't know. Let me get a quick nap in, maybe, or maybe some food or something. Maybe that'll help. But my eyes are just getting too blurry right now, and I can't. I'm going to stop if I go any further. So we'll come back later this evening, part 2. And if I, for some reason, don't, I'll come back and put a note on there. But again, let's just say 9 p.m. Okay, that's what I'll do. We'll return at 9 p.m. to finish that up and to get started on at least one of the Gladstone pieces. I'll probably do the Martian Jones piece, because that's the easiest one of the three. And then we'll talk about maybe doing Kid Nefarious and Libertina tomorrow or something. We'll figure it out. All right, folks. Sorry I couldn't go
a little bit further. I just need to take a break from it. And but in the meantime, I know some people wanted to see some of the artwork. Let me see if I've what we can do here. Well, actually, my cat's sleeping on the books. Hey, you want come on this? Come here. Sorry about the creakiness in my chair. Oh, that's right. Just go dead lip, you little monster. Here he is. There's the boy. There's the kitty boy. There's the midnight for everybody who wants to see him. Knowing what time it is, he probably wants to get fed too. But yeah, I will be back in a little while. And thanks for watching for now. And we'll see you at 9, I guess. That's when I'll show the artwork as well, I think. That way we'll get a good stream there as well. So again, returning at 9 p.m. We'll see you then. But for now, have a good one.